Over the past decades, humanity has pioneered technology once believed impossible. We've mapped the complexities of the human genome. We've expanded our understanding of the birth of galaxies. We've broadened our understanding of systemic inequities that continue to limit societal advancement. This progress has been the result of dedicated researchers working across disciplines and purposefully looking at problems through their diverse and unique perspectives. The current generation of university students is the most diverse in U.S. history. They look at the world differently than the students who came before them, understanding that collaboration is not just helpful for innovation and knowledge creation, but essential to effectively address the challenges of our time.
Part of what research universities have to do is be open to the ways that new generations of students bring fresh perspectives and ideas that can then fuel new kinds of inquiry. Sometimes that's not always so comfortable, but what's lost when we don't ask deep questions, when we don't push past the conventional wisdom, the solutions that are being proposed don't meet the moment. So the two questions, what have we learned and what's next? What have we learned really allows students and faculty to take up the question of the body of established knowledge. What's next is really the place where students and faculty can come together to imagine a new set of possibilities that may not have ever existed before.
I think what we've attempted to do in Science and Justice is to strengthen our civic capacities, to create spaces where we can stay in the room longer with one another and not run out screaming, like upset, right? It's really unfortunate when people see the tension as being a problem. I think it as the space of growth. It is, I think, important to our ability to grow both as a society but also as knowledge producers, to not shy away from the tension and the hard problems.
The best research is collaborative because collaborative teams challenge each other. It is not just asking the question, but it's the process of bringing together different points of view and challenging long-held assumptions, being able to push the team to think about questions and solutions in new ways.
The best places to successfully collaborate and innovate are environments that value the lived experiences of all participants. At UC Santa Cruz, we create spaces that encourage students, faculty, and staff to think out loud, to share their unique perspectives, and to explore new routes of inquiry. This approach is what pushed UC Santa Cruz in its relatively short history to become a world leader in genomics, creating advanced technologies and open source platforms to unravel evolutionary patterns, molecular processes, and the underpinnings of disease. Our students are transformed by their UC Santa Cruz experiences. They graduate with skills and motivation, partnering with those who see the world differently, working to strengthen problem solving, not stymie it.
When I look at our faculty, our students, what I see are, first of all, faces that look like California. They are diverse in every sense of that word. That's important. To address the world's biggest problems, we need cross-disciplinary teams of students, faculty, and staff who can bring to bear on problems both unique skill sets but diverse perspectives.
You know, the makeup of our students force those voices to be part of the conversation. We of course need to amplify those voices effectively, but as a result, what you create is, you know, this much more transformative academic environment in which basically faculty and students are challenging each other to actually create something more powerful, more beautiful.
I think almost everybody who comes to visit the campus is amazed and awed by its beautiful surroundings. It really is an iconic place.
UC Santa Cruz has a campus in the Redwoods, a campus in the heart of Silicon Valley, and a coastal science, marine science campus on the cliffs overlooking the Monterey Bay. Our students can be immersed in the environment where it's most relevant and they have the biggest impact.
I think students who are interested in questions of ethics and justice will find a very interesting space on our campus. We are the only university in the world that has a science and justice program. Our focus is on the larger questions, on the collective questions, on the questions of justice. These are questions that have fallen outside of the purview of conventional bioethics, but are absolutely vital. I wanted to do this pioneering work. I wanted my work to be oriented towards justice, and this was a campus that embraced that.
Particularly in the astronomy landscape, I think this campus has a unique footprint. Two neutron stars, the two densest objects in the universe, came together, produced a burst of gravitational waves that we detected on Earth. And then our students basically were able to actually capture the light coming at the aftermath of that. The story is actually incredibly beautiful because a grad student in our department who had a background in software engineering designed the code that allows to actually be first in the discovery, you know, and his first generation Mexican-American student, just to highlight that scientists don't necessarily have to have this straight path, but you know, you can take turns and you can basically adapt, and those live experiences make you a better scientist. And in fact, we had a 1 meter telescope and we were competing against people that have 4 meter telescope, and it was all about that software design that allows us to be first.
Our student body really remains so committed to their own curiosity. Curiosity about the communities that they have come from, curiosity about the knowledge that exists here, and about creating new knowledge. The spectrum of possibilities that they imagine for themselves is really breathtaking.
The future of UC Santa Cruz is a really bright one for enabling the future that we all want. And we're in a place that allows us to really think future forward in our actions, in our deeds, in the questions we ask, and in the way we educate students. That's why I'm here. That's what I'm excited about.
UC Santa Cruz, creating tomorrow's leaders, doers, and problem solvers. To learn more, visit ucsc.edu.